Profits, Passions, Fruit Farming, and today I want us to cover on part two of the previous of this series. So in part one we discuss on pruning from a grafted area to 30 centimeters below the wire. So we said there is nothing should grow between, and today I want us to cover on mostly the factors that contribute to frequent pruning, and we will not waste a lot of time, so we're gonna go direct. So number one is fruit during fruit period. So the fruit period, mostly when the fruits are there is a lot of fruits, you have to remove the leaves in order to expose the fruits to the sunlight so that they can have they can turn the color to a purple or yellow if you are farming yellow passion fruit. So then in number two we have during or after the flowering. Like for example, in my occasion I happen to harvest like all the fruits, only few which are left. Now we can use that time to prune. Now this time you have to prune like all the branches that was holding the fruits, so you can cut them and reduce them. So you have to prune after the harvest, after you have almost, because in a passion fruit farm it never lacks fruits in any time of the year. So but there are some times when there is less fruits, so you have to prune. So and number three we have flowering period. So before flowering period, so before flowering period is when the suckers will start to produce. Right now I'm supposed to prune to prepare the passion fruit or the vine to produce more suckers for flowering. So you have to prune before the flowering begin, so you can prune and remove the branches, dead branches, or even more fruit and more leaves. Then we have number four, we have seasons of the year. So sometimes seasons of the year can contribute in frequent or infrequent pruning. So we have like there is a cold season. In cold seasons, a passion fruit vine tend to produce excess leaves or excess vegetation, so you have to remove that excess vegetation for it to be productive. So also on dry weather, that is dry and hot weather, we also remove excess leaves in order to prevent excess loss of water, such that it will help the vine to maintain its shape and also help the fruit to maintain its weight. So we also do the pruning during the hot weather and also during the cold weather. So then number five is the spacing used. Sometimes the spacing can cause you to frequent prune, because we have interspacing and intraspacing. So the spacing between these vine and vine in the same line can cause you to prune, because if they are too close to each other, that is less than 3 meters, you have to come often to prune or to remove the excess leaves, because it creates a micro temperature, a microclimate, which is conducive for excessive growth of vegetation. So also line to line, that is from one line to the other line, also you have to consider the spacing. Mostly should be 2 meters, or sometimes you can use 3 meters. For example, mine I've used 2 meters wide, so you can use, so spacing is a very key factor. So if you put the correct spacing, there will be less pruning But if you reduce the spacing, you'll increase the number of pruning. So then the last one, we have the age of passion fruit. So the age of passion fruit, for example, this mine is around, if you look, it's almost like 2 years. It has not completed 2 years. But if it grows old, or it may be 4 years, if it is 4 years, you'll have to do more pruning than within 1 year or 2 years. So the age also determines the number of pruning you do. You can do pruning throughout the year. I want to emphasize here on something. There are other reasons that can cause you to do pruning throughout the year, not a specific point or a reason. One of the six factors that I've talked. If you find a dead branch, you can't let it to remain in the vine, on your vine, because it will distract the other production of that vine. So you have to remove the dead branch. Also, you have also to remove the excessive leaves. The excessive leaves, or the old leaves, maybe, for example, throughout the year, you'll find like there are dead leaves. Dead leaves are those which are brownish in color. We have the brown in color. Then you also have semi-dead, or I can call it almost dead. So those leaves which have turned from green to gray or brown in color, those are leaves almost drying. So you have to remove them. Also, we also have green, dark green leaves. Dark green leaves are these leaves which have a very, these leaves, they are very dead, they are very dark in green, in color. So you have to remove them throughout the year, irrespective of which time or which time of the year is it. So then you also have to remove maybe a dead vine. If, for example, this vine dies, and that vine and the other vine have joined together, so you have to remove the whole vine. You have to put the whole vine down. Last one is to cut the wrong strings, or the wrong branches or strings. So the strings from the top to down, you don't have to let them touch the ground. Mostly you have to cut them. Like, for example, I have cut mine because I need them to produce other suckers from up. So, for example, this one, it is almost touching the ground, almost. So I have to cut it. So when I'm cutting, I said you can use a sharp knife or a scissor, like this one. So you have to cut. And then where I cut, I just cut this point because it's where the fruit was. So if, for example, if it doesn't have a fruit, you have to cut it up there. Up. So thank you for watching my video. And please don't forget to watch the part 3 of this series. In part 3, we're gonna be covering mostly on the exact areas and how you're supposed to do it in order for it to be effective, and also to prevent diseases during pruning. So subscribe to my channel if you have not done so, and also like and share. Thank you.